Hey there, I'm Andy Farke. I'm a dinosaur expert. I'm also the director at the Raymond M. Alf Museum of Paleontology and a big ceratopsian horned dinosaur fan, a little bit of everything. And I'm really excited today to watch through the Jurassic World Dominion trailer. Now, I'm going to be honest, I've watched it once already, just kind of in passing. I was half asleep. So let's see how it goes this second time, you know, because I definitely have some thoughts. All right, so off we go. Ooh, landscape. Okay. Whoa, dinosaurs in snow. Parasaurolophus.
I wanted to show them something that wasn't an illusion.
Oh, wow. People on horseback. All right. Oh, okay. Hey, look at this. Parasaurolophus. This is a dinosaur I love. I've actually, with our museum crew and our volunteers, we've collected some specimens of this. One thing that's cool is that they have this animal as front and center. It's not just one of those dumb T-Rex or Velociraptor or something. One thing I wish they would have shown, maybe we'll see this in the movie, is what the juvenile, the babies, the little guys looked like. This is a, you know, kind of the adult anatomy for the specimen. And we know from even a fossil here at the Alf Museum that the skulls looked very different. So I guess sort of selfishly, I'd really love to see a life stage similar to our own famous Alf Museum specimen in the trailer. Maybe we'll get that in the movie. Oh, more dinosaurs in snow.
We can see and touch.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oversized sauropod.
Creation.
More dinosaurs in snow.
It's an act of sheer will. Life will find a way.
All right. Here we go. Very amber colored.
We can't keep her here.
Oh, no. Can I keep it?
They find her, we're never going to see her again. We got to protect her. That's our
job. Oh, wow. More dinosaurs. This must be the blue one. All right. Yay. Not in snow this time. Oh, wow. Shark cage. Hey, that's not a dinosaur. That's a mosasaur. Oh, well. Hey, look. It's a T-Rex.
Ellie Sattler.
Alan Grant.
All right, this is awesome. Okay, I have to be totally nitpicky in that this is clearly at a field dig. I don't know of any paleontologists that actually have a tent set up like this. I know I just used the word actually, but I'm going to actually say, okay, actually, this is not how a typical, you know, dig headquarters would be. They even got like the little skeleton there in the background. Like nobody in their right mind would take that out to the field with them. Oh, I see like the little conspiracy theory string things out back. Yeah, this is not like a typical office, although I guess like if this is a really loaded financially expedition, maybe they do have, you know, someone to haul all this stuff around. Wow, lots of filing cabinets and stuff. Random things hanging from the wall. I mean, I would love to have the sort of resources to, you know, be able to have a camp like this. Cool. Good for Ellie Sattler. And also great to see a paleobotanist as the, you know, front and center, right there.
You didn't come out all this way just to...
Okay, Sam Neill has way more hair than I do.
You coming or what?
That's great. All right, oh, more dinosaurs in the mountains. Oh, wait, I got to back up just a little bit and see. Do we have any juvenile... Oh, no juvenile Parasaurolophus. Now, this is a missed opportunity here. Why aren't there any in there? I guess maybe I'll have to watch the movie and find out. Okay. Oh, something with feathers.
We're racing toward the extinction.
Therizinosaur, something like that. There you go.
We not only lack dominion over nature.
Oh, they said the word dominion. Okay.
We're subordinate to it.
That must be the title of the movie. Okay. Oh, here's like. Oh, dinosaurs with feathers. Okay. Now this must clearly be something like to make every well actually paleontologist about feathers a little bit happier. I'm assuming like the arm posture is good and all that stuff. Yeah, this is cool, you know. I'm sure there's things to pick nits about, but hey, there's feathered dinosaurs in this. I'm sure that'll get explained. Really nice to see. Cool. Oh, wow. Are those pterodactylus? Flock of pterodactylus? Okay, what is it with motorcycles? We really need awesome bro motorcycles? Oh, whatever, I guess. Cool. Oh, here comes the pterosaur.
That's another plane, right?
Not exactly.
All right. That's cool. Oh, Nasutoceratops. I love that thing. Here's trivia. I was actually on the research team that helped describe this. It was headed by Scott Sampson, Eric Lund, Mark Lohan, and Catherine Clayton. Fun paper to work on, you know, naming this dinosaur. I guess if Nasutoceratops is in Jurassic World, that means that me as a character must be canon also, along with the rest of them. That's cool. Hey, there's Nasuto. Awesome. Oh, little dinosaurs. More dinosaurs. Oh, more dinosaurs. Oh, there we go. Real dinosaur. Don't move. Their vision is based in movement.
Why do they always have to go bigger?
Okay, fan service, but fun. And more amber. Yay. Cool. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing that. I've kind of not really paid attention to a lot of the ones lately, just because I've, you know, had small kids and stuff at home, so my movie time is pretty limited. But, you know, this might be one I'll actually go out and see in the theater. It's kind of cool to see, you know, ceratopsians and hadrosaurs and all these other dinosaurs front and center. I mean, I guess we got to deal with those things with big sharp teeth also. But, you know, this could be kind of cool. You know, the Jurassic Park movie was pretty important for me when I was a kid. It was really inspiring to see dinosaurs brought to life on the screen. And I'm excited to see that they're, you know, trying something new with some of these, making, again, you know, these feathery, dynamic animals once again. And also a few new animals thrown into the mix. I'm sure, you know, great merchandising opportunities. You know, so as one of the co-authors on the Nasutoceratops paper, I hope I will get a small cut of that sweet, sweet money from the movie. So with that, that's my thoughts on the new trailer, and look forward to hearing from all of you. Thanks, and bye.